Friends and family often ask why I bother to dive in the UK, saying it must be pretty cold and murky down there with not much to see. And yes, you can get some pea super dives where the underwater world is green and visibility is pretty bad, but thankfully it's not always like that. Cornwall is one of my favourite places to dive in the UK. The waters tend to be a bit clearer here, and you can dive north or south coast depending on which way the wind is blowing. Above the kelp, two spot gobies can be found filtering the water for food. But head for the seabed, get close, and watch as the bottom comes alive. Cuttlefish hide amongst pebbles. They're members of the cephalopod family, like octopus and squid, and are capable of changing skin texture and colour to mimic their surroundings. A flatfish rests on a bed of discarded shells. They start life looking like conventional fish with a vertical swimming position and an eye on either side of the body. But as they develop for life on the seabed, one eye moves to join the other on the same side of the body, and they end up looking like a fish that Salvador Dali would paint. Scallops hide amongst a forest of tube worms. They're members of the bivalve mollusk family and feed by filtering nutrients from the water. Trumpet anemones are normally found in the Mediterranean, but can also be found in the slightly warmer waters off the Devon and Cornwall coasts. Crustaceans are numerous and varied in size and shape. They spend their time scavenging for pretty much anything that they can lay their claws on, as well as filtering nutrients from the water. Leeches and long-legged spider crabs can be hard to spot, as they cover their shells with pieces of algae and sponges so that they blend in with their surroundings. Velvet swimming crabs are easily identifiable by their evil-looking red eyes. Their rear pair of legs are flattened to form a swimming paddle, making them agile and fast enough to prey on even fish and prawns. Harbour crabs are another type of swimming crab and will quite often stand their ground when approached cautiously by divers. Edible crabs are built for strength instead of speed, relying on the thickness of their shells to protect them. Spiny spider crabs, like their smaller cousins, camouflage their shells with seaweed and sponges, so despite their large size, can be hard to spot when they're still, but when they move, their orange and white legs are easily seen. Gobies are abundant in Cornwall and can easily be distinguished from blennies by the two dorsal fins on their back compared to only one on the blennies. Tompot blennies are comical looking fish with real character. They're found hiding in crevices and can be very territorial, but with a permanent grin on their faces, it's hard to take their threats and displays too seriously. All too soon, our time underwater has come to an end, and it's time to follow the starfish towards the shore and back to dry land.